best things are always made of the finest ingredients. Just a touch of this, just a touch of that. So how about a touch of France? Let's discover France, French and France in Ghana in a new episode of Touch of France.
Hello, bonjour, bienvenue, welcome to Touch of France, the show that tells you about France and France in Ghana. My name is Anne Sophie Avé. I am the French ambassador to Ghana and a lover of all things about France and Ghana. Today, we are going to talk about literature. Yes, and to do so, I am having an amazing guest. You know her beautiful face, you know her talent of an actor, an actress, but what you may not know is that she is also a beautiful brain. She loves to learn, she's a hard worker, she is always learning, reading. Yes, this is my friend Jackie Appiah. Hey, hello, darling. That's the way we have to go. Please have a seat.
Thank you.
Welcome to the show. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
We see you on the billboards, we see you on the covers, we see you on TV, but we hardly ever see you in interviews.
Yeah.
I am so blessed you are. And I can't wait to have a conversation with you. So let's settle down and we'll have a short commercial break and we will start our conversation with Jackie Appiah.
As a man on a mission, I am constantly on the move. My work takes me to different places from all walks of life. In the process of time, I have met many successful people with different backgrounds and with different drives. One thing has been common among them all. Like me, they don't compromise on quality. Which is why, each day as I leave home to face the world, I drive straight to the one place I know I can reach you over the day. Because I am assured of quality fuel at an affordable price.
Numa! Over there, Mama, it's a big
triple S.
Know your name.
Make them tell you. Sato Social Distance Health.
Here at Santo, quality is affordable.
Santo Energy, clean fuel, friendly service.
Welcome back to Touch of France. I am here in my sitting room overlooking Paris with Jackie Appiah. Jackie, you are an amazing character. People know you for being an actress, for being a beautiful, probably the most beautiful smile here in Ghana. What don't people know? What is behind this beautiful face?
What people don't know, wow. People don't know that I'm actually a shy person.
Really?
Yes, I'm really, really shy. I only get the energy or the spirit when I'm in front of the camera. But then after you go cut, I recall back to my shell, into my shell, yeah. So I'm really a shy person.
So is that why you went into acting? Because then you are putting yourself into a different character?
Could be one of the reasons. Most people are surprised to find out I'm shy. I'm like, if you're shy, how are you able to act? You know, but that's where I find myself. I feel comfortable whilst acting. I don't know where this break comes from, but once they say action, I'm a whole different being.
And how did it all start, actually? Because you began your life overseas in Canada?
In Canada, yes.
And then is that when you started acting? How did you realize that you were good at it?
Okay, so when I was a little girl in Canada, I remember watching a show called Barney. Mm-hmm. And I told my mom that I wanted to be part of this because they wrote underneath a 1-800 number to call if you want to be part of the kids on the show. Uh-huh. So I'm like, yes, I want to be part. So I told my mom I want to be part. And she's like, okay, let's call the number. So we call the number and then we find out that the taping is it's being shot all the way in New York. So. Mm-hmm. It wasn't going to be possible because I was all the way in Toronto. Yeah, so I'm like, okay, it's never going to happen then. So, but I actually didn't give up. I was probably around 7, 8, I can't remember, 6, 7.
Oh, really? That early?
Yeah, 6, 7, 8, 10. I don't know. It's a long time ago. I can't remember the exact age. But then, so I was acting in school.
Yeah, oh, were
you? School plays.
Right.
Yes. And then when I now finally moved to Ghana, I started taking part in the church drama, you know, the action, Christian Action Faith Ministry. We used to have a drama group called The Representatives, and I was part of the drama group. And yes, so I used to do like plays all
but
over.
But was it exactly like something you actually dreamt of? Because playing like a theater play, the moment you begin, you roll the whole thing all along. But when you are in a movie, you play bits and pieces and then cut, and then you have to get back into the character again. That's quite disturbing, isn't it?
Yes, it is. But once you're on stage, you can't make a mistake, you know.
Yeah.
But I think the stage gives you that proper training, you know. Mm-hmm. It grinded me, gave me that training. It's difficult. Yes, because you can't afford to make a mistake. Yes,
yes.
Obviously. And then we switched to, then I switched to acting around 2001, which was Thing to Do for Love. Yes,
oh,
Thing
right.
to Do for Love. And then I think I liked it because you're allowed to make a mistake and start all over again.
Yes.
You know, so yes, yeah, so.
So you think it's easier?
I think it's easier, honestly
okay.
speaking. It's much more easier.
So the theme of the day is literature. So to get started and warm up, let's have a look at what the French do in terms of literature. And then we'll get back to you and literature because there is a connection there that people don't know. So let's watch this and we'll be back.
Historically, forms of writings have evolved. In Western Europe, including France, Greek and Latin were used by scholars from the ancient times to the Middle Ages. Literature in the French language approximately dates back to the 11th and 12th centuries. This corresponds with the creation of the first universities and famous texts such as Legends of the Round Table Nines by Chrétien de Troyes or Le Roman de Renard. During the European Renaissance in the 15th and 16th centuries, artists including poets such as François Villon, Joachim du Bellay, or Pierre de Ronsard, or again prose writers such as Rabelais, attempted to rediscover and modernize lost values and philosophy of the ancient times. Through science, printing and distributing books on a larger scale soon became possible. The discoveries of new continents also brought new critics and reflections on science and humanity, such as in the well-known Essai by Montaigne. The 17th century marked the beginning of an intense production of literary works. It came with different opposed visions of what literature should be. It ranged between classics by La Fontaine, Racine, or La Bruyère, for example, and moderns by Charles Perrault or again Molière. The period encouraged the production of literary works, with, for instance, the creation of l'Académie Française, the French Academy, although under the control of absolute monarchy. In the 18th century, literature became more common, moving from the courts to the salons of enlightened people. It paved the way for the French Revolution with the development of new ideas by les Lumières, the Enlightenment, the cultural, philosophical, literary, and intellectual movement. Questions spanning across topics such as rights and privileges, forms of government, the place of religion in the society, and slavery were raised. It was also a century of theater and progress of education. More people were exposed to drama by Beaumarchais or comedy by Marivaux. After the French Revolution, literacy and education became widespread and eventually compulsory. New genres to literature also became common, from Romanticism with Lamartine, Nerval, or the most famous writer of the 19th century, Victor Hugo, to Realism with Stendhal, Balzac, Maupassant, Flaubert, and of course Zola, as well as popular literature with Jules Verne, or poetry with Baudelaire, Rimbaud or Verlaine, and later Mallarmé or The Suisse, Blaise Cendrasse. In the early 20th century, more writers from foreign origins adopted the French language and started writing in it, following the steps of Sophie Rostopchin, aka La Comtesse de Ségur from Russia, or of Apollinaire, of Polish origins. Different influences and political ideas also became common during the period and were translated into numerous literary genres. French literature was particularly prolific. With time, publishers became very renowned and literary creation was also encouraged through the instatement of award schemes such as the Goncourt, Renaudot, or Médicis. With comics from France and Belgium, children literature, detective novels, among others, the book industry became popular and books were made more affordable. Did you know that the book industry is the first cultural industry in France and is worth 4.5 billion euros? That is as twice as the cinema industry generates for the country. Also, over 80,000 people are currently employed in the sector. Indeed, literary production in France is in good shape. Authors of French language publications in France, such as Leila Slimani, Leonora Miano, Michel Houellebecq, and Virginie Despentes are known all over the world. Their works are translated in more than 50 languages.
Yes, France is the land of literature. Just it generates as much as the cinema does. Can you believe this?
Yes, amazing, amazing. But they didn't talk about a favorite writer of mine, a great philosopher. Auguste Comte.
Oh, is that? Oh my God.
Yes, I learned about him.
Wow, I'm impressed. Yes. So you're a reader.
Yes.
Can we share a little secret here? We actually met, you and I,
yes,
shooting a movie where you were playing a writer.
Yes,
I was playing a publisher. And because I'm French, I couldn't help bragging about the fact that the French was actually the language of literature.
Sure, yes.
So we have a little footage of it.
Okay,
can you
really?
See me bragging about it when you present your new copies of your book?
Wow.
Let's watch this. Okay.
Hi, Anne. This is the latest. I'm working with the title, If Roses Were Horses. Title's intriguing already.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm French, right? So when it comes to literature, we know what we're talking about, and you are really good. No wonder the headquarters are the one to play with.
Wanting to make a compliment, we brag about ourselves.
Uh-huh.
I'm French, so I know about literature.
Yes, yes, yes.
And
yes.
You are good.
Yes.
So yeah, have you ever dreamt of being a writer, or do you write a bit?
I've never dreamt of being a writer. But I do admire writers,
right?
Because I think writers are great. How they are able to think out of the box, you know, how they're able to put stories together. Like, I'm like, how did this writer even think of something like this, you know? So I respect them so, so much. I read scripts all the time, and seeing how the writers put situations together, you know, seeing how the past writers,
mm-hmm,
like the Auguste Comte I spoke about, he was a philosopher way back, and he talked about positivism and how people used to use religious reasons to solve their problems, as in if they're sick, they attribute it to spiritual a spiritual affair. And then he was trying to say, no, it might be different. So we don't. And then you see that happening right now. You know, we see the
visionary.
Yes, yes. So they think ahead of time. You know, so I do.
I'm so impressed because I mean I'm French, and for that matter, I'm not going to brag. I don't know Auguste Comte as well as you do.
I like how you pronounce his name.
so impressive.
Thank you.
Wow.
You,
yeah. So how did you prepare yourself to play the role of a writer?
I had to research.
Mm-hmm.
Every character that I play, I need to do some research. If you're playing a lawyer, you're playing whatever, a doctor, and I was playing a writer this time around, so I had to research on writers and their mannerisms and how they talk and how they think. And writers are crazy people. Like, they are wackos. They are crazy, excuse me to say, you know. That I think because...
Well, they live in some sort of imaginary world.
Exactly.
That's how they can think of the box.
So it was quite fun and interesting having to study a writer and then bringing it out into a film. Yeah, I enjoyed it.
Well, I'm quite impressed about your knowledge about writers and as a reader. We have found a Ghanaian person who is in France. I'd like to introduce to you. She is Georgina Atta, and she tells us about her experience in France and the books she likes. Okay. Let's watch her.
My name is Georgina Atta. It was 18th March of 1996. I'm an entrepreneur. I work as a brand strategist. I've been freelancing for the past couple of years. So I would suggest three books. The first one would be Mélancolique Moi, Lettre à Malesherbes. The second one will be Gaël Faye, Petit Pays. And the last book would be L'Éloge de la Défaite by Laurent David Samama, which is a new author, and it's very actual, very modern, and it talks about losing in life and how to accept it and how to move forward and how it's part of, you know, the human experience. It's a very good book. For me, it was easy to learn because I was 9 years old, so I think I learned French in 2 months. So my favorite French song is a song by Celine Dion called Si suffisait d'aimer. Je rêve son visage et décline son corps. Et puis je l'imagine habitant mon décor. J'aurais tant à lui dire si j'avais su parler. Comment lui faire relire au fond de mes pensées.
Ghana has such amazing talents around the world. She's amazing. She's very impressive. She's so knowledgeable.
I'm impressed.
Very. Have you been to France yourself?
Oh, yes, of course, many times. I was at the Cannes Film Festival.
Yes.
Went on the red carpet, the Hollywood stars.
How does that feel?
I was proud of myself, you know.
For a movie, or you?
I went to view a movie.
Yes. But were you presenting one?
No, I was not presenting. I went as a guest.
As a guest?
Yes.
But how does it feel when you walk on the red carpet that everyone has seen on television, walked by the most famous American, French, and international artists? I mean, it must be so thrilling.
It was. I went there with a bright color. I went with our kente cloth. So everybody there was amazed with the African print, you know. So they're like, wow, where's from? They started taking pictures. It was nice. My limo dropped me off and went on the red carpet, met great people, met producers, you know, made some friends. It was great. And then I met actresses from around the world, you know, and actors from around the world. You know.
Okay, if you have any gossips about my favorite, I will ask you off the record. I've got a few actors I'm much a fan of. So in France, when you were there, did you try the French cuisine?
Yes, I did.
But like in a restaurant, or did you stay with some French people who cooked like family food?
I guess in my hotel.
Yes.
What did I say? But I love the croissant.
Croissants. Nice.
How do you pronounce
croissant.
It?
Croissant. Oh, that's very difficult. Croissant.
Croissant. I love the croissants.
When they're just nice and warm out of the oven, crunchy and soft inside.
Exactly.
How do you like them? With jam or just...
I love the cheese croissant.
Oh,
cheese.
Wow. Yes, okay, so the salted one.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
That's delicious.
Yes, it's nice.
That is delicious.
When it's hot,
And I love the smell of it.
Uh-huh.
Well, yes, indeed, we have a lot of pastry in France. Do you know the tarte tatin? Ever heard of it?
Okay. No.
So let's see the recipe of it. Okay. Might ring a bell.
Okay.
Let's watch the tarte ta-ta-ta-ta-ta.
Bonjour les amis, aujourd'hui il fait très beau sur Paris et nous sommes devant le musée d'Orsay. Le musée d'Orsay était une ancienne gare ferroviaire qui a été transformée comme musée par le président Valéry Giscard d'Estaing. Nous allons éplucher nos quatre pommes, puis les couper en quarts. Ensuite, nous allons dans une poêle préparer un caramel avec le sucre et un petit peu d'eau. Nous y mettrons nos pommes à cuire. Puis, nous ajouterons un peu de sucre vanillé et le beurre. Et nous recouvrirons pour éplucher notre pomme et les couper en quarts. Pour le caramel, il nous faut notre sucre, un petit peu d'eau. Il faut surtout faire attention à ne pas se brûler les doigts. Nous y ajoutons le sucre vanillé, un petit peu de sucre, et les noisettes de beurre. Voici 45 minutes dans notre four. Et voici une superbe tarte tatin. Et pour déguster notre tarte tatin, notre tarte renversée, puisque c'est ainsi que les sœurs tatin ont nommé la tarte qu'elles avaient renversée, eh bien je vous propose de l'accompagner soit de crème fraîche ou soit de crème glacée à la vanille. Je vous souhaite un bon appétit!
Beautiful pastry, French pastry, definitely not a diet food, so not for me.
Amazing, right. I want to try it.
You want to try that?
Yeah,
well, I could try apples. And cook one for you.
Please,
I could try and bake
please,
one for
please.
You. And not that good, but I could try that.
I love apples and I love caramel, so.
Yeah, it actually tastes wonderful with cream or ice cream. Do you know the origin was actually supposed to be an apple tart?
Exactly, I love apple tarts. So,
right, yeah. And the sister Tatin, they had presented it. One of them, when presenting it, stumbled, flipped it on the floor, put it back together, and presented it like a bit upside down.
Okay.
And that's how it became the tarte tatin.
Wow.
Interesting. Right. Okay. So let's think of it. I will try and rehearse the recipe. You can find the recipe as well on our social medias, Facebook, and watch it again on YouTube, the channel. Meanwhile, we'll have a small commercial break, very, very small one, and we will be back. Of France. So I'm here having a conversation with Jackie Appiah. We just discovered the tarte tatin. And now we are going to go a bit further in France. So you were in Cannes. Anywhere else?
I went to Nice.
Nice, right?
Where else?
Oh, you've been to Paris. Of
yes.
Paris.
Yes. Favorite spot though is Champs-Élysées.
Right? Because of the shops?
Exactly.
Yeah.
So
yeah, sales times is better because otherwise really hard for, your Visa card.
I'll get the sales days.
The sales days, yeah. So sale. Actually, we have a whole week of sales beginning of the summer, but it's quite overcrowded.
Oh, okay.
I don't know about you, but I go for the sales. I always want the new collection, actually. So I'm quite useless in this. Have you ever been to Bordeaux?
Bordeaux, no.
It's in the southwest. Well, do you like wine?
I don't drink alcohol, so no. But do they make wine in Bordeaux?
Famous Bordeaux wine, which is a red wine.
Okay.
We French like to have a small glass of wine with literally everything.
Okay.
So I'm going to take you to Bordeaux.
Wow.
Okay, so you can discover Bordeaux. Let's
see.
Fly to Bordeaux.
elle me prend dans ses bras, qu'elle me parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose. Elle me dit des mots d'amour, des mots de tous les jours, et ça me fait quelque chose. Peut-être pas compris quand je t'ai dit en quittant Paris, je m'en vais le cœur lourd, mais je sais bien qu'un jour, dès que je le pourrai dans ton pays, je reviendrai. Toi qui ne m'avais rien
That is a very, very romantic destination. It's a nice change from Paris. But you may wonder, how do I get a visa to go to France? Well, there are a few things you need to know. So let's have a quick overview.
So you want to travel to France and need a visa. France is part of the Schengen zone. Hence, a visa to France gives you access to travel across all 26 Schengen countries. Never pass through an agency or intermediates. It is a scam. There is only one way to apply for a Schengen visa at the French embassy. There are various visa options. Make sure you submit a complete application. Make sure you have an appointment. Walk-in is not allowed. Do not submit fake documents. It is an offense and could put you on a travel ban. Plan in advance. Do not apply at the last minute.
The only way to apply for a visa is to go to france-visas.gouv.fr and nowhere else. So I'm sure you have your visa, your Schengen visa.
I use a Canadian passport.
Oh, you have a Canadian
free
passport.
Entry, yes, right. Most countries.
So you can every country. So back to our literature. What are you currently reading? What do you like to read normally? Is that always philosophy? Because that's very intelligent. Or politics? Do you actually read novels?
Oh, yes, I do read novels. But I'm actually reading every single day because I get tons of scripts that I have to read myself to see if I want to be part of the movie or not. You know?
Right.
So even if I don't want to read, I have to read. I'm forced to read. Because I need to know the character, I need to know if the story is a nice story. So yeah, it has me reading every single day. Different types of stories, good, bad, ugly.
What matters to you when you read a story? Is it the story? Is there suspense? Is there something that, is it taking the viewer into some history that is interesting? Or do you also pay attention to the lines that you're going to say, if the lines are good, if it might be funny, or if it bounces nicely? Do you pay attention to the whole thing? Or what matters the most in the script? What makes you say this one is a good one?
Okay, so from the lines, the language, to the suspense and how everything is plotted. Now, if I'm reading a script and I am glued to the script and I can't put the script down, I don't even want to touch my phone or stand up to go and use the washroom, then I know it's a good script, you know? Right. So there's some scripts that keep you, like, you want to know what's going to happen next. And when the language is beautiful, that's an extra plus, you know? And how it's plotted and everything is very, very important.
And when you read the script, do you already picture what the result will be? Do you already imagine what the movie will be when it's all done?
Sometimes, yes. Of course, you do imagine how the movie will look like, but sometimes what you imagine is not how it comes out. Sometimes what I have in my head thinking, sometimes I'm like, okay, it's going to turn out this way. But then when it's edited and you see it, then it's a whole different ballgame altogether, you know. So sometimes, yeah, it changes, yeah.
Right. Yeah. We do a lot of things here, the embassy in of France. We do a lot of things in Ghana, but we also do things in literature to promote the French literature as much as to promote French, well, writers in French, maybe Francophone, or even Ghanaians, actually, they were really good. Let's have a look at what we do here in Ghana.
Okay.
Ghana is a country of complex concepts and practices, symbolized, for instance, by Adinkra symbols, kente, or tales transmitted by oral tradition for centuries. As a result, it is not surprising the country has been able to produce major literature writers, playwrights, and philosophers since the end of the 19th century. From J.E. Kesley Hefford, Mabel Dove Dankwa, Kobuna Sechi, or Raphael Amato, to the rising stars of Ghana's independence, Ifwa Sutherland, Joe the Graft, Kofi Awuno, not to mention Kwame Nkrumah himself. Ayikwe Ama, Margaret Busby, and Ama Ata Edo all deserve honorable mentions for their contributions to literature in Ghana. Before gaining independence in 1957, Ghana hosted several foreign writers and often activists such as W.E.B. Du Bois or Maya Angelou. Although unpopular, two famous French writers from Guadeloupe and Martinique in the French Caribbean, Marie Scondé and Frantz Fanon, were also received in the country during that period. Marie Scondé even lectured at the University of Education Winneba up to 1969. Relatively, Frantz Fanon, who is also known for his commitment against colonialism and his friendship with French philosopher Jean-Paul Sartre, became the ambassador of the Provisory Government of Algerian Republic in Ghana after the Pan-African Congress of Accra in 1959. It's been more than 60 years since Ghana became an independent state, but literature is still an important bridge between France and Ghana. Although Ghanaian classics are hard to come by in French in France unless retranslated, younger talented authors from Ghana or the diaspora, such as Ni Ayikwe Parks, Aisha Haruna Atta, Ya Jesse, or Taye Selassie, are making significant contributions by making it accessible to Francophone audiences. In 2019, the translation of Aisha Haruna Atta's 100 Words of Salaga in French led to the organization of a public discussion during the most vibrant Ghanaian literary festival, the Paja Festival. It was organized by the Writers Project of Ghana at the Goethe Institute. Institut Français du Ghana often produces books and works of literature made in Ghana, such as the journal Something We Africans Got in 2020. It highlighted the literary scene in Accra, including clubs like Team Volvox. Institut Français du Ghana also organizes frequent talks with Francophone authors for youth or adults and supports production of literary works. In 2021, for instance, the Embassy of Lebanon, with the support of the organization, awarded the first prize for Francophone writers in Ghana during the Francophonie Week. A young teacher from the Saint-Pierre Claver Catholic School of Kaneshi was awarded with the first prize for his novel by a jury including two authors, Nabi Malat from Lebanon and Mabrouk Rachidi from France. Comics production is also a priority for French cultural cooperation in Ghana. In 2020, the young Squid Mag creators of Squid Mag Inc., an online magazine dedicated to African comics, took part in France's most important comics festival in Angoulême to create links with the French industry. Alliance Française's library offers you the possibility to immerse yourself in the very best of French and Francophone literature thanks to a wide range of books available to the public. You can tell literature is and will definitely remain of prime importance for French cooperation with Ghana.
Yes, that's what we do together in France and Ghana with France. While we were watching, you were telling me something about the scripts that you were reading.
Yes, I wanted to add on that sometimes you read a script and it's so wonderful, it's so great, and then you watch the movie and it's
you're disappointed.
Yeah, disappointed. Yes.
What is it? The editing, the way.
So if you have a bad director, you have a bad editor, it won't come to life. Mm-hmm. Yeah, what you read won't come to life. So it's
always a risk. So even when you read a very, very good script, you're not 100% sure it's going to be a great
product. Yeah.
It happens a bit when you read a novel that you really liked and you pictured the whole thing, and then you watch a movie that is from that book.
Novel, yeah.
And sometimes you get very disappointed.
Mm-hmm. With the novel or with the film?
With the film, usually.
Yeah.
I usually read the novel first.
So that's exactly what I'm talking about, yeah.
Yes. Yeah. So there's another way of writing as well, that is writing music, lyrics, poetry. Do you like music?
Yes, I do like music.
Right?
I don't have a nice voice. I can't sing.
No, I'm not going to ask you to. Don't worry. I'm not going to ask you to.
Just telling you in advance.
Yeah, okay. So I'm warned. So, but you do listen to music.
Of course. I love
it. Do you know some French music?
Ah, good question. So, old African song also.
Oh, right.
Oh, my God. I can't remember. Puzzle. I don't know if you've heard it before, but I don't know if it was Maybe who sang it. I might be wrong. Yeah, but it used to be a nice song. Yeah.
Oh, wow. We'll try and find it. Well, today, normally in this show, I am presenting a French singer or a French song that people probably know because it's very universal, it's across the borders, but they probably don't know that it's French. But today, I'm going to reverse that. We have Ghanaian singers who have become stars in France.
Okay.
And you probably don't know. Wow. The first one was in 1985.
Interesting.
So as long as that. The top of the chart in France was this song. And it was quite amazing because in interviews people asked her when she was from, and when she said Ghana, there was like a bit of a silence.
Where's Ghana?
And people knew, footballers maybe heard about Jerry Rawlings at that time.
Yes.
Then she, in 1986 she was again top of the charts with this one.
Wow.
I don't want to know. Yeah, she looks familiar. She is definitely Ghanaian. Her name is Bibi Brew.
Okay, I almost said she looks like Grandma Brew.
Name's Bibi Brew.
That's her sister, yes.
Huge star in France.
Wow, what's she? I didn't know she was that big in France.
Oh, she was very, very big. She was top of the charts. We were all singing along.
Amazing lady.
She was absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, wow.
Well, so we do love, of course, these Ghanaian stars. And even we have a contest that's called Eurovision.
Okay.
And we had to pick up someone to represent France. So there was a contest to decide who would represent France. And the person who was in all the way to final, unfortunately didn't win, he again was a Ghanaian with this song.
Oh,
is a very, very nice guy. He's now a star in France. He's doing concerts. His name is Sifaz.
Sifaz from Ghana as well?
From Ghana. He was born in Navrongo. Can you be more from Ghana?
Wow, okay. He is Ghanaian.
He is very Ghanaian. Yeah, very Ghanaian. And he was adopted by a French family, and that's how he speaks French so beautifully.
Wow, shot well. Wow.
He's really, really, really good. He's got another song that's also a great success. Let's see that. Oh, 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 depuis toi.
Wow,
I love those songs. Yeah. I just love them. And it's in French, and he's Ghanaian, so that he's a bridge between our two countries. And I really hope his songs become successes here in Ghana. Actually, when he heard that you were here on the show, because he knows you, he wanted to address a message.
Wow!
He couldn't be with us because he hasn't been in Ghana for a long time, and he dreams of coming back, but he has a message. So let's watch Sifaz. What do you have to say, Sifaz? Hello.
Hello, Anne Sophie. Hello, Jackie. And hello to you, my motherland, Ghana. First of all, sorry I'm not able to be there with you today. Hopefully next year it'd be okay and I'll be there. So yeah, I'm Ghanaian born from Navrongo, the north of Ghana, where I lived for about 9 to 10 years before being adopted by a French couple who lived in South Africa by the time. So I left Ghana. I left Ghana to live with my parents in South Africa, Cape Town, where I did my college in English. And 8 years later, they decided to live South Africa for like Mayotte, which is a French territory, where I learned to speak French from scratch. I didn't understand a word. I promise you, it was hard, but I made it. I don't know how I made it. So 2 years later, I came to France and continued high school. And when I finished high school, I started working at a theater in Toulouse, where I spent like four years of my student life. And at a certain point, I came across my manager, my first manager ever, who presented me to a composer from Lyon. So somehow he managed to convince me to sing in French. And I did this first song called Depuis Toi. Which was played on every radio in here in France. It's crazy. It changed my life. It changed everything. And then I did this second song called On a mangé le soleil. On a mangé le soleil. On a mangé les étoiles. And with that song, I participated at the Eurovision Song Contest, the French selection. And yeah, it was a great experience. So yeah, that's about it. Thank you, Touch of France, for having me. Thank you, Anne Sophie. And I hope to see you soon in Ghana, in person. Kiss.
Isn't he cute?
Yeah, so, so cute. And songs are really nice, well shot, everything, like so professional. Professional. I'm really impressed.
It makes me very proud that very a Ghanaian proud. Sings in French and becomes a star. Yeah. And it must make Ghana proud that some Ghanaians make it in
this
France.
It's international. Wow.
It's very international.
I'm impressed. Yeah.
So we hope you come to France soon, Sifaz, and to Ghana soon. So we can meet you, and kisses to you too. So now we'll have a short commercial break. And then we will have a little touch of French with Jackie. No, I can feel you're nervous. Yeah,
oh,
a little
Lord.
Touch of French just after the break.
MPS Terminal 3 is Africa's new state-of-the-art container terminal at Tema Port. For manufacturers, agro-processors and traders, the new port means business can be done faster. This infrastructure boost will improve Ghana's port handling capacity, connect more trading routes, and oil the engine of growth for the economy, creating greater opportunities across all sectors as Africa's markets merge and become the largest trading bloc globally. MPS, we connect, you thrive.
Welcome back, Touch of France, now a touch of French with Jackie. Jackie, yes. You grew up in Canada. Canada
yes.
shares both English and French.
Yes, but I was in the English part of Canada.
Toronto, indeed.
Yes, indeed. So I was learning French in school.
Really, in Canada?
In class, yeah.
And is there, so do they have the same Canadian French accent when they learn French from Canadian English? Do they pronounce it the same way? Because it's a very singing accent, the Canadian one.
I hear people say Canadian French is broken.
No, it's not broken. Okay. It's nice.
It's nice? Okay,
it's nice.
Yes. Their accent, you know, I love French in general because I feel that they all have, Canadians have the curse down. Yeah, so it sounds the same for me. The accent, yes. When a French person is speaking, yeah, it's the different accent towards. Compared to someone who speaks English,
No, it's not broken at all. It's singing, and actually, it's even more genuine than the French, because they translate every single English word. When we just use the English word, they will translate it and make it French. Okay, so, what do you remember from your French courses?
Bonsoir.
Bonsoir. That's good evening.
Au revoir.
Yes. Au revoir.
I used to, there's this funny story. When I was young and I came to Ghana, because people knew I was from Canada, they thought I could speak French. Yes, so they're like, can you speak French? I'm like, oh, yes. And then I'll be like, oh, so speak French. I'm like, oh, je parle français. I'll just conjure all French words together and they'll be thinking I'm speaking French. It took like a year or 2 years for them to find out that everything I was saying was a lie, like, the words, I was just making up French words and just...
It was acting French. Already.
I was acting already, you know. Yes, so I always used to put to a beat, I'll put French words together and then... And I could even sing in French and I wasn't saying anything and they used to believe me. Yes, it was fun then. Yes, but I just remember something. It depends. Maybe you can ask me some words.
Yes. How about literature? Oh, that's an easy one.
Okay, because you taught me that,
Literature. It comes to literature. We French think we're the best.
I remember that line.
How about to write?
To write.
Écrire, yes, that's right. How about writer?
Writer. Écrivez?
Yes.
Écrivez.
Okay, so you're also pretending you can't speak French, but you can. Okay, what's a book?
Book. Livre,
yes, that's right. Livre, absolutely. Livre. And what's to read? Sounds a bit like it.
To read. Oh, are you saying what is to read?
Read.
You ask me what to read?
Yes.
Okay.
Begins the same.
Lire
un livre. That's a lot of livre. Lire un livre. And so I was actually playing the role of a publisher. Mm-hmm. How do we say publisher in French?
Okay. But I'm not thinking cap because we shot recently. Editor.
Yeah.
Okay.
I didn't think you would find it because it's actually what we call a false friend. Okay. Because you also have a word editor here.
Yes.
In French, it's monteur.
Yes.
So we all have different words, but actually, publisher, yes, it's an editor. Wow. Okay. You impressed me so much.
Thank you. Now, let's see
if our viewers will impress us too. So you don't say, because I thought you wouldn't know, but now I know you could find the right answer. So don't give it away. I'm going to ask our viewers a question. the quiz for today. What is the French word for novel? Novel. What is the French word for novel? Is it nouvelle? One. Nouvelle. Number two. Is it roman? Or is it three? Nouveauté. Nouvelle, roman, nouveauté. What is the French for novel? If you know the right answer, you dial 1, 2, or 3 at 1788. And today, the award is a couple of beautiful scarves from Segby. Look at that, Bogoland, Segby. Oops. You have a white one, you have a black one, and of course, you have a mask. Isn't that beautiful? So if you're a man, you can give it to your wife or your girlfriend if you're a girl. And if you win, you will have this beautiful, beautiful scarf. And it is so beautiful that I've decided that I would offer one to my beautiful guest, Jackie.
Thank you.
There you are. This is for you. And it would actually match your outfit of today, wouldn't it?
Yes, yes. Thank you. It's beautiful.
So if
it does match my...
That is your color.
Yeah, same material. Yeah, that's nice. Thank you.
So thank you to Segby for these beautiful scarves. And yours, if you're the winner of the award, here it is. This is yours. I keep it carefully. Jackie, this was so short.
Yeah, I know. Are we done?
Yes, we are.
Wow, okay.
Can you believe it?
That is short.
So I leave you the last word.
Thank you for inviting me. Thank you to all my amazing fans out there for supporting me. An advice to the young ones right now, always be humble, remember where you're coming from. There's no rush to success. Everything takes time. Rome was not built in a day. I've noticed that some of the young ones out there are in a rush to make it. One used 20 years to achieve, what I used probably 20 years to achieve. The new ones come in and they want to use a year or 6 months to achieve. And it's not possible, you know? So you need to take baby steps, relax. At the right time, things will take place. So just relax and take things one step at a time. I love you.
And what's amazing, when you mentioned you started in 2001, which is 20 years ago, I can hardly believe it.
Yes.
Thank you so much, Jackie, for being with us.
Thank you.
So the show is now over. So you can find the replays on YouTube, the channel Touch of France Ghana. Then you can follow us on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter. It is now time for me to leave you. I want to thank our sponsors for today. Saint-Ol, Decathlon, Bolloré, Serene, Tract Afrique, Orca Deco, Nasco for those beautiful screens, and of course, Segby for those beautiful scarves. Thanks you all. It wouldn't be possible without you. This show is also thanks to you and thanks to my beautiful guest, Jackie Appiah. As I usually say, bonne semaine. See you next week, same time, same place. Until then, have a great week. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup. Bye-bye.
On va bouger le monde. On va bouger le monde. In your household, is the touch of France in your mind? Is it time for Ghana make a big step? Is it time to dance to the vibe? If you know what it is, then you know what I mean. From Accra to Paris, is how you gonna feel. It's what you wanna see, it's what you wanna feel, it's what you gonna be, yeah. Is it touch of France from Ghana? Is it touch of France from now? Is it touch of France from Ghana? Is the touch of France? On va bouger le monde. We'll be right back.